The assembly of the axles and wheels is called a wheelset. In this video, we will learn about the wheelset assembly. The movement of the rolling stock on the track is possible only with the help of wheels. A wheelset is an assembly of two wheels, fixed to the axle by interference, and they rotate along with the axle. These wheels are provided with a flange towards the inner side, which guides the wheels to travel on the rails, and does not allow it to fall down from the track. In 1789, Englishman William Jessop designed the first wagons with flanged wheels that were grooved, allowing the wheels to better grip the rail. This important design feature was carried forward to later locomotives. Let's see the different parts of a wheel. Wheel hub. Wheel flange. Back face rim. Wheel front face rim. Wheel tread. The rails are tilted or inclined, slightly inward towards the center of the track. The angle of inclination is different. For example, 120 is used within the UK, whereas 140 is used in the USA. The inclination of the rail provided by the sleeper, designed with concrete or steel sleepers. Let's see the different forces of the contact area between the rail and wheel. Point of contact on tread. Vertical force V. Lateral force L. And resultant force. All these forces will be explained in the Cant deficiency topic. Bearing plays a vital role between two rotary moving parts. Bearing works as an anti-frictional element and reduces frictional losses. And if you want to learn more about spherical roller bearing, please check out our next video. Thank you. Let's grow up. Never stop your learning.